I'm going to be teaching the Clyde Brown RISD studio. This will be my fourth studio at RISD, about the first time teaching in the Brown 402 program. And it should be very interesting, and of course, RISD students are welcome. So we hope to get a good mix. I encourage everyone to consider it. The title is called Fabricating Machine and Gardening, and this is Hans Holbein. It's a beautiful work, actually, work on paper, of course, about this idea of modernity and industrialization, its relationship to landscape. Obviously, this is a very provocative image, but also very much out of scale to the investigation that we're working at, because we're going to actually look at the micro scale and micro housing. So bring it down a notch here, we're going to look at domesticity in that context as kind of accessory dwelling unit. And this product is an examination of the house or the house type within a broader landscape context, in this case public space of the Farnsworth Museum. A way of examining how the house could be unhouse-like, being private and veiled, and kind of conceal itself from the public domain, but also expose conditions of domesticity that were essential and shared, like a driveway or a parking area. So when we talk about micro housing and accessory dwelling units, this is what you get most of the time. This is kind of the paradigm within the U.S. Not that there's anything wrong with that, but so our goal is to challenge this notion of living within the context of 600 square feet. And I like this project because this is a home housing, micro housing in Beijing, which is to me a wonderful example of how the program, the micro program at 600 or 700 square feet has exploded quite physically, and the work that's about is realizing an uncharacteristic but exquisite kind of composition. Our site is going to be in Cambridge, what appears to be a kind of mass here is actually a pretty well organized suburban community. This is just outside of Harvard Square. And you can tell from the kind of figure down morphology of the site that it's pretty well characterized single family, detached single family house. And really looking at a site here that we're very familiar with. And it's a 1/3 acre site, very conventional in many ways, but it has some richness to it and opportunity, I think, to explore this. How do we get there? So we're gonna look at things like serialization, fabrication, kit of parts, transportation. This project looked at a kit of parts approach to build a kind of garden concept that could be serialized and transformed as needed by the rearrangement. Thinking of cartography of form, where we look at, and we will do this using tools at hand. Those of you who are interested or have the capacity to write algorithms, this is an example of an algorithmic approach to form making, using, again, a small kit of parts, but their arrangement becoming developed in their form and developed through a kind of hands-free design process of algorithmic form making, which really develop this. So as we develop the work in the studio, we're going to become much more invested in the use of the computer, not just for design, but also for fabricating. Understand the role of computer, CAD, algorithm, and such, is a way of conveying information that can be translated into fabrication means, which in this case, this is an image from Blueprint Robotics, which is a pretty interesting organization that builds houses based on digital files, and it's all interiorized construction, shipped to the site, dropped in place. Sometimes I think the level of specificity of design has to blend with the idea of generalities, meaning generalities being something derived from a system that is very mundane, like a SIPS. In this case, this is a project that has a high level of specificity in this element which supports a telescope. And it has a structural component as well, so it's based on the supported needs of the telescope, but also supporting the structure around which these kind of general system of SIPS panels are locked in place, which renders an unusual and typical form done with exceedingly simple palette material. When we start the studio, we'll be doing work by hand, and gradually developing into a language of digital design and fabrication. The studio is intentionally limited in its scope. 600 square feet is the program, so that students can really develop a high level of resolution and investigation.